Good morning.
Yes.
So what about your revision? Going well?
Ma'am, I was busy this week.
Okay, no problem. So last class we discussed about chapter 14. Okay, chapter 13 is deleted for you. Chapter 13, okay. So chapter 14, we already almost completed our chapter 14, health, nutrition, and hygiene. So I'll just quickly summarize for you because last class you were absent, right, Sanjana? So I'll just quickly summarize. Okay, a quick summarize. So look here, there are four parameters of health. Okay, we can't tell someone who is only physically active. We can't tell him or her as a physically fit person. Okay. Almost all the ones, the social health, mental health, spiritual health, physical health, all these are the combinations of health, not only the physical health matter. Okay. Our mental health is also very important, right? Like our physical health, our mental health is also a factor. So these four are the parameters of health. Okay. Learn the term parameter. Physical, social, mental, and spiritual. All of these are connected to each other. We call them as parameters. Okay. And usually, who provided all the healthcare facilities here, Sanjana? Who are the responsible person?
Hospitals.
Hospitals, right? Okay. Almost all the healthcare facilities they are provided in India, we provided in three ways. One is primary, secondary, and tertiary. Okay. Primary care means almost ever the primary healthcare centers and all. The initial treatment, that is primary care. Secondary means our community hospitals and last one, tertiary care. All the things or all the treatments are provided by tertiary care, like our medical colleges, the AIIMS and all. Okay. Amrita Institute, all of them are the tertiary care, which means almost all the diseases, almost all the things are cured by them. Okay. We call them as tertiary care. So the health care, that simply means it's the maintenance of our health. Okay, in India, the health care is provided in three ways. One is primary way, secondary way, and tertiary way. In primary way, the initial treatment is provided. In secondary, a normal treatment is provided. Last one, that is high treatment or the maximum treatment is provided by the tertiary care. Okay, and what are the benefits of proper nutrition? Actually, we already discussed this. I'm just revising. All these are the certain benefits of weight management. Proper intake of food that help to avoid the binge eating patterns, and also you can easily manage your weight, growth and development. It's very important, right? The good nutrition that is always connected with our growth, our height, our weight, everything is connected with our nutrition. Then lifespan, immune boosting, protect from non-communicable diseases. Which are the non-communicable diseases? Give one example for that. Non-communicable, which means it's not communicable, right? That's the meaning. Non-communicable diseases, like think
Ma'am, allergy.
allergy. Not all the allergies, but it's okay. Okay, any other diseases, like what about stroke, heart attack? Yeah, all these are the cancer, all these are the non-communicable diseases. Then our mood also matters. How our mood is connected with nutrition of food. Why we eat chocolate at certain time? It's connected, right? They are also connected. And then our mental health is also connected with proper nutrition. Proper amount of iodine is very important. Proper amount of iron is very important for concentration, attention span, and all. Okay, so the nutrition is always connected with our mood and mental health. All these are the certain benefits of proper nutrition. And then, okay, this topic is very important, I'll tell you. Listen carefully. We discussed about macronutrients and micronutrients last class, right? Macro and micro. Macronutrients means the nutrients we require in larger amounts, which are the carbohydrate, protein, fat, and water, right? So 1 gram of carbohydrate, they give, suppose we eat or we ate 1 gram of carbohydrate, they provide 4 kilocalorie of energy. Kilocalorie, that is a unit for energy. Okay, so 1 gram of carbohydrate, they provide 4 kilocalorie. 1 gram of protein, they again provide 4 kilocalorie. 1 gram of fat, they provide 9 kilocalorie. Is it clear? Okay, this is a difference. okay, you have to learn. Okay, please note it. 1 gram of protein, that gives 4 kilocalorie. Kilocalorie, KCAL means kilocalorie. That is a unit of energy. Okay, this is a measurement of energy. So about the macronutrients, 1 gram of protein, that gives 4 kilocalorie. The one difference, that is, if we eat 1 gram of fat, they provide 9 kilocalorie. Please note it. Okay, this topic is very important. Measurement of energy. So we discussed about the benefits of proper nutrition, the care, the primary, secondary, and tertiary, and also parameters of health. Okay. And about our vitamins, vitamin A, their function, it's there in your textbook. Okay. That you have to buy hard. Page number 140, 141, and 142. Okay, what is the function of these vitamins? Which are the sources? What will happen if this vitamin A is deficient or vitamin D is deficient? Okay, so you have to learn this table by heart. So I'll just quickly summarize. The vitamin A, that is very important for eye and skin, right? That's why we drink carrot juice, or we give more importance to vitamin A for our skin and all, and also for our eye. And vitamin D, that is connected with our bones and our teeth. And vitamin D, that is very important for the absorption of calcium, that is connected. Okay, for someone who is deficient in vitamin D, automatically in that person, calcium absorption is also in problem. Okay, because the calcium and vitamin D is connected. Vitamin D is very important for the absorption of calcium. Someone with a good vitamin D, their calcium absorption is also going well. Because we need this calcium and vitamin D for bones and teeth. Is it clear? Okay, and the vitamin E, that is very important for the reproduction and also for healthy skin and all. And vitamin K, that is known as clotting of blood. And the common sources, that is cabbage, soya bean, beans, spinach and all. You have to learn this by heart, the symptoms. Okay, please look here. This is all the symptoms of vitamin D: muscle cramps, fatigue, a bone, joint pain, mood swings. That is one of the most important symptoms of vitamin D deficiency. I'm deficient in vitamin D. If you have these kind of problems, you have to check your vitamin D deficiency, because it is very important for your calcium absorption. Otherwise, you will always feel pain in your joints, bone, and leg pain, leg cramps, muscle cramps, and all. All these are the symptoms of vitamin D deficiency. Okay. Then, yes. Let's discuss about minerals. Okay. Minerals. There are two classification, like the nutrients we classified into two, macro and micro, like that. And vitamins we also classified into two, right? Water soluble vitamins and fat soluble vitamins. Here, the minerals are again classified into two, that is major minerals and trace minerals. Please note, Nestle, please note. Okay, minerals, there are two type of minerals. One is major, another one is trace. So what is the difference between major and trace? Nestle, can you try? Why we call them? Totally 24 minerals are found in our body. Okay, 24 minerals are found in our body, and they are classified into major elements and trace elements. So why this name, trace and major? Think about our macro and micro and tell me. Nestle, I can't hear. Okay, Sanjana, it's your turn.
Ma'am, major minerals are needed in larger amount, and trace elements are needed in small.
That's it. Okay, very good. Very good answer. Major elements, that simply means the minerals required in larger amount, like calcium, phosphorus, sodium, potassium, all of them are the certain minerals our body needed in larger amount. In the case of trace elements, which means the amount is very small, the iron, iodine, and you checked your blood amount, right? Or hemoglobin in blood. Okay, what will be the amount? Any idea? Last time check.
13,
yeah. In my case also 13.8. Actually, it's deficient, right? 14 is normal. Okay, So eat more amount of dates and all. We also having same amount of hemoglobin, 13 point something. Nestle, what about you? You can use the chat box, okay? If there is any problem with your voice. If you have textbook, it's better to take page number, just a minute, page number 399, our last page. Yes, the last page of our textbook. Okay. Look here, protein. What about the value of protein for a man? 60, right? 60. Yes. What about calcium? 600, right? 600. Look here, our major mineral, that is calcium. 600, because the value is more, right? What about iron? Iron value of men?
17.
It's a lesser value, right? When we compare with 600 and all, that's why. What about iodine and all? Is there any value there? No. Okay, so almost these calcium, phosphorus, sodium, potassium, magnesium, chlorine, they are the minerals we needed in larger amount. We call them as major minerals. Trace means iron and all, 17, 14, lesser amount. Okay, the body only needs a small amount. That's why we call them as trace elements. At least learn three or two examples for trace and major elements. Okay, give two examples for trace elements. Identify the trace element from the following group. Suppose your exams will be in MCQ, you have to find out which are the trace elements or which are the major elements. Okay, so please learn iron, fluorite, iodine, silicon, zinc, copper, they all are the trace elements. Okay, please take your rough book or any page. Just a minute. Take your rough book. Okay, please write calcium. Write calcium. Okay, calcium is rich in the source. Please write milk and milk products. Calcium, the sources, the common source that is milk and milk product. Suppose if a person who is deficient in calcium, the deficiency diseases, they are called as rickets. And osteoporosis. Please check the spelling. Osteoporosis. Osteoporosis. Calcium deficiency that leads to the condition called as rickets and osteoporosis. Okay, so someone who is deficient in rickets, what will be your idea to improve or your knowledge? What will you tell them about or to improve their calcium level? They have to drink milk and milk products because they are the good sources of calcium. Okay, someone who is deficient in calcium, these are the deficiency diseases, rickets and osteoporosis. Okay, next one, sodium. Someone who is deficient in sodium. Okay, so common sources, that is our normal salt, right? The potato, beef, all these are the sources of sodium. Common salt is the best source for sodium. Okay, so sodium deficiency that leads to the condition called. There's any idea what will happen? Someone who is deficient in sodium. Any idea? It's hypertension. Please note the condition, hypertension. So it's better to check our sodium level during the time of exams and all, right? Hypertension, sodium, okay? Next one, please note, potassium. The good source, that is banana. The best source of potassium, that is banana. That's why we eat banana during our periods time to avoid the cramps and all, because the potassium, they have the capacity to reduce our pain, the potassium level. Okay, so banana is a source. It will lead to the condition called as weak muscle. Weak muscles. Next, that is an easy one, iron. So iron is a trace element, right? Iron, that is a trace element. Calcium, sodium, potassium, all of them were the major elements. Iron. Iron deficiency leads to the condition called as anyone. It's easy, right? Iron deficiency. Anemia. Right. Anemic. Common sources at our dates, jaggery, spinach, all these are the common sources of iron. Iron is a trace element. Next one. Iodine. What about iodine? Iodine is also a trace element, right? Iodine? Yes or no? Please check the table. Yes, iodine is a trace element. Iodine deficiency that leads to the condition called as goiter. Anemia and goiter. Iron deficiency that leads to the condition called as goiter. Okay. Almost all the seafoods are the rich sources of iodine. Onion, garlic, it's not onion, right? Onion, that's the correct pronunciation. Onion and garlic, they are the sources of iodine. So other than this, okay, all these are the minerals. So last class, we also discussed about vitamin C. Please note, there is another name for vitamin C, that is ascorbic acid. You have to by heart all these names. This is another name for vitamin C, ascorbic acid. Okay, what is the specialty of vitamin C? Any idea? Is it a fat soluble one or a water soluble one?
Water soluble.
Water soluble. So what will happen if we cook gooseberry or lemon? Almost all the nutrients will be lost, right? So what we are doing before preparing pickles and all? We are cooking it, right? So all the nutrients, what will happen to the nutrients of gooseberry or lemon and all? They will lose, right? So it's better to eat all the vitamin C foods without cooking. Okay, because this is a water soluble one. Amla and all. This leads to the condition called as scurvy. The deficiency disease of vitamin C or vitamin C, that is scurvy. That simply it's a condition of general weakness, the weakness of a body. S-C-U-R-V-Y, scurvy. Okay. So another name for vitamin C, that is ascorbic acid. The deficiency of vitamin C, that is called as scurvy. Yeah. Next one, please note, vitamin A. Vitamin A, the rich sources, that is almost a yellow vegetables, green leafy vegetable, egg yolk, that is a good source of vitamin A. All these are the sources. Okay, the deficiency diseases, that is night blindness. Night blindness. Keratomalacia, please note. Malacia, always remember that term. Keratomalacia. Okay, this is an eye condition in which cornea gets, our cornea, it's a part in our eye, right? So the cornea gets cloudy and it softens. That condition is called as keratomalacia. All these conditions are related with the eye, okay? Vitamin A, that is connected with our eye. Please connect like that. It's a condition of cloudy cornea or keratomalacia. Okay. A-D-E-N-K or DECA. This is a code, right? DECA. These are the fat soluble vitamins, right? Vitamin A, D, E, and K. Okay. D is always connected with our bones and teeth. A with the skin and eye. K, that is for blood clotting. E is also connected with reproduction, the reproductive organs, healthy skin and all. Okay, so let me ask a question. The deficiency disease of iron is called as?
anemia.
Deficiency disease of iodine. Check your note. No, scurvy. That scurvy. C is there, right? Scurvy. That is vitamin C. Goiter. This is the major problem. Someone with a goiter, their thyroid gland, it's increased. Okay, the thyroid hormone, goiter, that is connected. Goiter. Okay. Iodine deficiency that leads to the condition called as goiter. Let me check. Just a minute. I don't have the picture with me right now. Chapter 13 is deleted. Okay, please note that. Okay, so what about the group who are at more risk for malnutrition? Can you please tell me? Who are most at risk from malnutrition? What about infants or children, preschoolers, pregnant mothers, lactating mothers, elderly people, those who are about 80, 60s and all, and people with low income? Because it's difficult for them to buy foods or the nutritious food for them. Okay, that's why all of them were the certain groups who are at more risk from malnutrition. In the case of infants, preschoolers and all, that's clear, right? Because that age group, they are directly connected with their parents. They depend more on parents, right? So the parents who are having low income, what will happen if they find difficult to find out food for their children? And pregnant mothers, lactating mothers, because they need more amount of nutrients for their body. Just learn these group name. Okay. More informations are there in your textbook, because we are following NCERT here. This is another publication. That's why, okay. So just note down, these are the group who are at more risk from malnutrition. Just the names, okay, who are at more risk. Our infants, preschoolers, pregnant mothers, lactating mothers. Lactating mothers, that is clear, right? Another name, that is nursing mothers. Both are same, nursing mothers or lactating mothers, those who fed the babies. Our breastfeeding mothers, we call them as lactating mothers. Then elderly person, people with low income and chronic diseases. Chronic diseases means diseases are last for long period, 1 year, 2 years, cancer and all. These are the chronic diseases. They are at more risk from malnutrition. Malnutrition, that means both over and under nutrition. Okay, not only under nutrition, malnutrition, we include both under and over nutrition. Okay. And what are the effects of malnutrition? What will happen? What are the effects of malnutrition? Leslie, please use the chat box. Yes. Sanjana, you can tell. Okay. First, Leslie. What are the effects of malnutrition? What will happen to a person with malnutrition or with a micronutrient deficiency or macronutrient deficiency? No. Okay, Nesla. Sorry, Sanjana.
Ma'am, there might be no physical effect.
Yes, growth and development, they are affected, then?
They might be sick and get some issues.
Then, anything else?
They are more vulnerable to the infections and all.
Very good. Very good. Their immune functions, they are also affected, right? All these are the certain effects of malnutrition. First is low productivity. That means stunted growth, their growth, their development, everything affected. That's why low productivity. Next one, increased risk of diseases and death. You already told, right? Because their immune system is affected due to the malnutrition. So they are more risk of diseases and also the death. Vitamins and mineral deficiency can lead to various diseases and increases infections. The deficiency of vitamins and minerals, because it's connected, right? Vitamin A, what happened? The vitamin A deficient person, that leads to night blindness, keratomalacia, and all, right? So the diseases or the infections, everything increased due to the malnutrition or vitamin deficiency and mineral deficiency. Then poor school performance. Poor school performance. I already told you, right? Iodine is very important for proper functioning at school. Importance of iodine. Because iodine deficiency hinders the ability of children to think. That is very important, right? And also for the brain development of the fetus, iodine. The iodine, please note, iodine, that is very important for the development, for the brain development, and also for thinking power and concentration. Iron and iodine, they are very important for the school performance. Okay. And intergenerational cycle. Intergenerational cycle. This is very important. Suppose a malnourished mother will give birth to a low birth weight baby, right? And this low birth weight baby will grow as a malnourished child and again into a malnourished adolescent, and again she give birth to a malnourished baby. That is an intergenerational cycle. Malnutrition problem. Okay. And last one, poverty perception. Due to the poverty, malnourished child will grow as a malnourished adult, right? Poverty perception. That all these are the certain effects of malnutrition. Do you have any idea what is kwashiorkor and marasmus? No. Okay. That's easy. We'll discuss. Am I fast, Sanjana?
No.
Okay. Let's discuss about DD, that is deficiency diseases. Okay. It's in page number 145. If you want, you can check. Deficiency diseases. Okay. So the common deficiency diseases in India, that is PEM. This is very important for class 2 also. PEM is a deficiency disease. Deficiency disease means some vitamin or mineral is deficient. That is deficiency, right? Deficiency disease. So the best example for the deficiency disease or the common deficiency disease in India, that is PEM. Okay. So I'm going to write the full form, that is protein, energy, malfunction or malnutrition. Okay, both are fine. Malnutrition or malfunction. What is this? Double color and all. Okay, PEM, that means protein, energy, malfunction or malnutrition, which means protein is deficient in diet, right? That leads to the condition called as protein deficiency. If both protein and energy is deficient in a person, that is called as PEM, protein, energy, malnutrition. Okay, so there are two type of PEM. One is kwashiorkor. Please note the spelling. Please write, take your rough book and write kwashiorkor. K-W-A-S-H-I-O-R-K-E-R. Pronunciation, that is kwashiorkor. Okay, kwashiorkor. K-W-A-S-H-I-O-R-K-E-R. Okay, this is caused by protein deficiency. Only the protein deficiency that leads to the condition called as kwashiorkor. And next deficiency, that is marasmus. Marasmus. Okay, in this condition, both protein and energy is deficient. Calorie means energy. Okay. Kilocalorie. That is a unit of energy, right? So calorie, that means energy. I'll give a clue for this. Marasmus. This is a very sure question for next year and also for this year. Okay, marasmus, like a tree, right? A Malayalam term, yes? With so many branches. Okay, so one is energy, another branch that is protein. Okay, marasmus, with so many branches. Marasmus, protein and energy. Okay, and koshyoka, that is only deficient in protein. That is the difference between koshyoka and marasmus. This is very important, important topic. I'll repeat, a deficiency disease in common in India. The common deficiency disease, that is PEM, full form, that is protein energy malnutrition or malfunction. So the first condition of PEM, that is koshyoka, protein is deficient. So protein is deficient, that condition is called as koshyoka. And in the case of marasmus, maram, right? This is a clue for you. Marasmus, both protein and energy is deficient. This is the difference, okay? Koshyoka and marasmus. Chanjana, can you please read the paragraph with deficiency disease with C, page number 145. Please read the paragraph about the effects of malnutrition. Page number 145. Overnutrition and undernutrition, we already discussed. And then
from deficiency diseases?
Yes.
Undernutrition is sometimes used as a synonym of PEM, protein energy malnutrition. Two factors of PEM commonly exist. Children below 5 years of age suffer from acute or chronic PEM.
Koshyoka, so children caused below 5 years are affected with this koshyoka and marasmus.
Koshyoka, it is caused because of protein deficiency, whereas marasmus, it is caused because of protein and calorie deficiency.
Good. So that's all about our marasmus and koshyoka. Effects of malnutrition we discuss, and the last topic in this chapter, that is hygiene and sanitation. Okay, what is the difference between hygiene and sanitation? That's it. Yeah. Any idea? What is personal hygiene? We brush regularly, right? I hope so. And we bath daily. Again, I hope so. What is in need of hygiene? What is in need of hygiene? From first standard onwards, we are learning the hygiene, right? All the conditions, all the practices, the washing of our clothes, washing the vegetables, cleaning our body, cleaning our hands and nail trimming, everything. All these is a part of hygiene, right? But main thing, that is to maintain our health and to prevent all the diseases and to avoid the spread of disease. That is hygiene, right? Yes or no? I'm not asking, is it clear? Because we are learning this topic from small standard onwards. Hygiene. Okay. In the case of sanitation, okay, sanitation, it's a process of keeping places free from dirt, infection, disease by removing waste. Okay, that is the main difference of hygiene and sanitation, the removal and all, okay. I'll read, okay. Hygiene that helps to maintain health and prevent the spread of diseases. The personal hygiene, that simply means all our body cleanliness and all, okay, washing hands regularly, regular house cleaning, that is also very important to reduce the infections and spread of diseases. In this era, we all know, right, to prevent virus, that is also very important. And what about food hygiene? What about food? Personal hygiene, that is cleaning of our cleanliness, body cleanliness, our house and all, okay. So what about food hygiene? The proper cleaning of vegetables, the area we used, all these are the proper disposal of waste, kitchen waste and all, right? The collect the waste in correct dustbin, all these are the important. The cleaning of utensils, our vessels, all these are the part of hygiene. In the case of sanitation, that simply means it protects our human health and to prevent the diseases. like diarrhea and the proper disposal of human urine and the human waste, that's a part of sanitation. Okay, that is a major difference here we are discussing. And feces oral diseases like diarrhea, thyroid, cholera, hepatitis, all these we can prevent by the proper sanitation of a particular area. So sanitation means the collecting and disposal of excreta, human waste, community waste in a hygiene way. Okay, that is all about a sanitation. Okay, so food hygiene is there, personal hygiene is there. And then in the case of sanitation, please learn the definition. Sanitation generally refers to the provision. It's in page number 146. Please learn the definition for sanitation and hygiene. Please mark that. Sanitation generally refers to the provision of facilities and services for the safe disposal of human urine and feces. That means human waste. Okay. The word sanitation also refers to the maintenance of hygiene condition through services such as garbage collection, wastewater disposal. Okay, all these are very important for the cleanliness of a society or a community to prevent diseases. In the case of hygiene, that is connected with a particular person. Sanitation, that is for the whole community, right? That is the main difference. In the case of hygiene, hygiene refers to the condition and practices that help to maintain health and prevent the spread of diseases. So please learn the definition for hygiene and sanitation. Okay, so in this chapter, I'll tell the important points, Anjana. What are the parameters of health? Physical health, mental health, social health, and spiritual health. All these are the four parameters. And learn what is physical health, spiritual health, and all. And next important point, what are the benefits of proper nutrition? Only the points of weight management, height, weight. I'll give the notes. Okay, you can learn my notes and please read your textbook. Okay, this is another important point, that is the measurements of energy. We discussed, right? Protein, 1 gram of protein that gives 4 kilocalorie, 1 gram of energy that again gives 4 kilocalorie. It's in page number 139. Carbohydrate, you can see the last one, the 1 gram of carbohydrate gives 4 kilocalorie. Rich choices, that is cereals, pulses, and all. Okay, so you have to learn the sources, at least one source for one nutrient. Okay, vitamins, minerals, everything. It's better to learn from your appendix. It's in page number 393. You can use the table. Okay, you can use this table to learn the sources. Page number 393. Important sources are there. Okay, if you want, you can learn from the table because that's easy for memorizing. Okay. So two more chapters are there for this term one, that is chapter 15 and 16, that we will discuss on the next after your exam, only after your exam. Okay, so I'm stopping here. Next period, we will discuss our 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay, because maybe that's our last period, right? Last period for revision. Yeah. When does your exam start?
We are both at the 25th.
So that's Monday, right? So no other classes. So we'll revise all the 5 chapters the next period. Okay. So take care. Any doubt from this chapter? I'll send the notes. Please go through the notes. Please go through the PDF. And next class, please ask me if you have any doubt. I'll clarify it. Okay.
Ma'am, the portions is 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. 5 chapters. 14, that we are discussing. No. Just 5 chapters. Okay. Because I want to complete portion. That's why I'm taking along with it. Okay. Just 5 chapters for your term 1 examination. 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Our fabric, the 3 chapters, 10, 11, and 12. That's a whole about our fabrics and all. 8 and 9, one chapter that is related to nutrition. Another one that is related to resource management. The resources, human resources, and also we will revise in the next period. Okay. So take care. Bye.